Hi everyone, I just wanted to make a quick video documenting that this is the first day of my fast. For those of you who aren't Catholic, you're probably wondering what this is on my head. Today is Ash Wednesday, which is the beginning of Lent. And basically, all Catholics are required to go to Mass today. It's considered a holy day and receive their ashes. So I just want to give you guys a little bit of a heads up about how it's going to be going down during the fast. I have no idea if I'm going to make videos daily. I will make at least one video every week. I'm just going to make videos pretty randomly whenever I feel like it. And, you know, I'm not weighing myself during the fast. I did weigh myself this morning. I'll post that weight on my profile page if you're interested. And I'm not going to weigh myself again until the end of the fast. The only reason I'm going to weigh and record myself is to simply document for you guys that, yes, I actually fasted, because this fast is not about losing weight. This fast is for spiritual reasons, my own personal reasons, etc. I have decided to document this fast on YouTube because I believe that it's okay to fast in public and make your fasting known if it's for a good reason. And I believe that many, many, many people forgo fasting because they're scared of it. And if you could just go one day without eating, you would realize so many things about yourself, just one day of fasting. So for me to be able to fast every day during Lent, hopefully I will inspire some of you to consider even giving up one meal once in a while and maybe use the money that you save from that meal to help somebody else. So the whole point of documenting this fast in public is to inspire you to just even consider the action of fasting, even if you only fast once a month and you only fast one meal, or you fast once a week, all three meals, whatever form of fasting that you feel called or inspired to do. You know, I'm particularly called to do long water fasts, which I've done before and I'm going to do this time. Now, there are certain passages in the Bible that talk about when you fast to keep it private between you and God. There's other passages in the Bible that talk about fasting inside of your community and fasting for your community. So while I am documenting this fast on YouTube and hopefully some way inspiring you to possibly fast, even if it's on a very small level, that's the main reason I'm documenting it. Now, the other things that I'm fasting for and what I'm personally dedicating my fast to, I'm going to keep to myself. So there's a way to fast publicly and to inspire others publicly while keeping certain things between just you and God. So I had planned to originally make this video at night, so I might stop this and then splice in some things tonight just to let you guys know how the day went. I didn't sleep very well last night because I was doing a lot of reading, and just for me, fasting is almost like Christmas morning. So it's like, okay, now I'm going to fast. I enjoy fasting. A lot of people ask, oh, how can you fast for so long on just water? Something to remember when you're fasting, this is very simple, but it's certainly, it's helping me right now, and it's 1 o'clock my time. And something during Lent, no matter what you're giving up, even if you're not water fasting, maybe you're just giving up, you know, maybe you're just eating one small meal a day, is just to fast and forget it. And so what I mean by that is just, whatever you decide to give up for Lent, or, you know, when you are fasting, no matter what kind of fast you're doing, whether it's a Daniel fast or a juice fast, or like what I'm doing, a water fast, no matter what you're doing, just decide what you're going to do and then do it. I mean, there's no easy way. If you dwell on it and how inconvenient it is and how much you're suffering, you're not going to make it through. One of the very first fasting videos I ever made, I said, look, if you're scared of fasting, forget it, don't do it. Okay. And so that's kind of the same mentality with this, you know, just fast and forget it. You know, just if you're going to do it, just, you know, don't sit there and watch the Food Network. Don't go through every recipe book that you own, which is something that when I went to the fasting clinic 10 years ago in California, everyone loved to sit around and look at cookbooks. And I mean, that was valid for that experience, that was part of fasting there with that particular group of people. It's not something I recommend. Don't watch a lot of television, because, not necessarily because the program you're watching, but the advertisements. I mean, I don't have to tell you what type of advertisements come up when you're fasting. And just, you know, don't sit there and dwell on food, basically. No matter what kind of fast you're doing, even if you're just skipping one meal a day, don't sit there and say, oh, I just love breakfast so much, I can't believe I'm giving this up, and then fantasize about all the food you could be eating. It doesn't work. So, one thing I will be doing during the fast, since I'm not going to weigh myself every day, is I am going to at least once a week go and take my blood pressure. And that will be a good physical indicator of how my body's doing. And there's a couple other things I'm going to do, which I'm going to keep private. You know, I don't mind sharing this experience on YouTube because I think it's important. I think you can do so much with fasting, not just giving your physical body a break, your mental body. You can use it to make political statements. I mean, fasting is a very useful tool. And so I don't mind documenting it and sharing it with everybody on YouTube, but there's just some things as far as like how I'm monitoring my health and all of that, I'm going to keep to myself. What you need to know is that I'm safe, I'm an experienced faster, and I would never ever take anything like this on if I didn't know what I was doing. So I would not recommend that you just decide, okay, I'm going to do a 40-day fast because Fasting Girl 31 did it on YouTube. You need to at least be under the care of a doctor or a naturopath, someone who has experience with fasting, and you need to start off slow if you ever decide to do it. And like I said, if you can just start off with fasting one meal, you know, once a month, you know, hey, sounds good to me. So I might record longer videos, different parts of the fast. But as the fast progresses, you're going to see my face change physically. And like I said, I'm going to weigh myself again. I guess I'll weigh myself again. I'll videotape it, and then I'll videotape it at the end of the fast. And of course, you'll be able to see it on film. So that's it. I feel very calm. I feel very peaceful, and I'm very grateful that I have this medium called YouTube to document this fast and possibly inspire other people to fast for positive reasons. So if you're interested in the place where I did my medically supervised fast, the first one I ever did, there is a link on my profile page, so you can check it out. Okay.